Hey guys, I'm here with a video, pretty much showing one of the very few Tron toys I'll be getting, or the Tron Legacy toys that I'll be getting. Sam Flynn's Deluxe Identity Disc. Hoo hoo hoo. Now, there are two versions of this out there. This is the deluxe version that has lights and sound, and it comes with a stand. And actually, this kind of makes me feel a little better about it, but I'm not too hopeful. This is a collectible item, and is not to be used for throwing. What that means is there's another version that's, I think, half the price of this one. This one's about $20 retail. There's a $10 one that is also Sam Flynn's disc, and it's meant to be thrown. It's basically a frisbee, from my understanding, and it glows in the dark. This one, however, lights up and has sounds, all those fun doodads. Now, for those of you who have not seen Tron, it was made in, I want to say 1982, but I'm not positive. And I think it was one of the first movies to really utilize computer graphics, if not the first. But it stars Jeff Bridges as Kevin Flynn, and an ex-programmer who was fired from this company, Encom, started his own arcade and really ruined my whole hopes and dreams, because now I really want to have an arcade that has a loft built on top of it. That's it. That's one of my goals in life, is to have what Flynn had for his arcade. But anyway, he sneaks back into Encom with the help of his two buddies, Alan, and I forget her name entirely now.
Lara.
But anyway, to try to find proof of games that he had written that Encom is now producing and selling under his former boss's name, and his name is escaping me too. But anyway, in the process, he gets zapped by this digitizing machine that they have been developing and is zapped into the computer world, into the mainframe of Encom. And in there, he meets all kinds of programs, some that are like Tron himself, who is a program made by his buddy Alan. Flynn had one named Clue that was deleted, I think, at some point, or captured to some extent. And basically, Flynn helps Tron overthrow the Master Control program, this massive, hungry-for-information program that is controlling everything. And they save the computer world. They save Encom. The information's printed out. Flynn's returned back to reality. He has proof. And Dillinger, that's his name. Dillinger. He's fired. And Bridges takes his place. Tron Legacy takes place about 20 years later. And it has Kevin's son, Sam, who's trying to find his father, who is missing. Apparently, at some point, Flynn was zapped back into the computer world and has been trapped there for 10, 20 years or so. So, there's that. Real excited to see the movie. I think it's my most anticipated movie of the next year. And, yeah, so, enough babbling. This is the, Identity Disc. There's Sam. It's made by Spin Masters. Now, Spin Masters, I'm gonna go ahead and pull this out. It came with a little Try Me thing built in that I went ahead and pulled out, because, really, who needs that? Spin Masters is doing the Tron Legacy toy line, and from what I've seen, they really cannot do very much when it comes to action figures. I'm really not amazed by anything I've seen. They pretty much do like the Airhog stuff, which they are doing an Airhog type thing for Tron where the Lightcycle can crawl up walls. Fun, hunky-dory. But when it comes to actual action figures, I really don't think they can handle the license. I would have liked if somebody else could have handled this license. I don't really know what or who. But I'm hoping at some point Diamond Select gets a Tron license, because, oh, that would be so sweet. But here's the packaging for it. There is the back. You can see it has lights and sound effects, a display stand that I'm looking forward to. There's Sam, all that kind of fun stuff there. Now, the ID disc itself, it's pretty much, if you've seen reboots, it's pretty much like their little icons, their little triangle icons. It stores all of the program's information, all of their backup files, you could say, who they are. It's stored in there. They also use this for combat. When Flynn goes into the Tron world, he kind of competes in these gladiatorial games that are actually arcade games in the real world, such as Racing the Light Cycles, which is basically like the game Snake on your phone, just with two motorcycles. They would have this where the ID disc would be thrown at their opponent, and then, I forgot the whole point system for there, but the point is to knock your opponent off his pedestal with your disc. And it says there, very, very short, the ID disc is very essential to the program inhabiting Tron City. I don't remember being called Tron City, but maybe they changed it for the new movie. Not only does the disc contain all the data that defines who they are, but it is also a weapon that is used for combat in the games. So, yeah. So, while it's in package, let's just do it real quick. I'm really hoping there's more to it than that. But yeah, let's open it up. And once it's opened up, you have your ID disc. It does come with a little stand that has engraved Tron Legacy on it, which is a nice little touch. That folds out just to help display it. The disc itself, I'm delighted to say, it feels like it's made not just for small children. My hand can fit in it pretty well. It feels like it's scaled somewhat nicely. I can hold it like this. My finger's not really in the way. I can hit the button and do that kind of stuff. It feels like it's scaled nicely. I was really afraid it would be about half the size of this and for little small children so they can be like, just, yeah, Tron! But luckily it's not. Now, when you get it, it is in Try Me mode. So when you hit the button, of course, you get your sounds. The speaker, you can probably notice, is very, very quiet, which I'm not a fan of, but you can hear a little better there. And that's really about it. Now, the real fun thing about this is you look on the back here, there is a little, the E is Try Me, the 0 is off, the I, or the 1 is on. At least I'm pretty sure the O is off. Yeah, it's off. So, put it to on. I'm going to kill my light for effects. So now, you can see the light's flickering on its own. When you hit the button once, it powers on, I think, pretty cool little effect. And it will continue flickering like this for a while. And it's meant to be so you can have it in its little stand. And it'll just kind of flicker on its own, which is exactly what I wanted. I wanted to have an ID disc on a shelf that hit a button, it'll stay lit up on its own for 10, 20, 30 seconds by itself. That's exactly what I wanted. So I feel that my purchase was justified. It's fantastic. Now, the real play nature of this is that it's got the whole interactive thing to it. The button no longer has sounds, nothing at all. To get the sounds, you have to bang it. And you can see how everything lights on the front. And just to show a little bit better, look at that disc, woohoo! So let's bang it. And my camera's gonna have a fun time targeting that. There you go. It lights up very, very nicely, and I like this. So again, for some of the sounds, where's the speaker? I keep losing the speaker. There we go. Again, very, very quiet, but it's going to be on a shelf, so I guess I can't really fault it too much for that. Of course, if you leave it, it will go into its standby kind of sleep mode, so I'm just going to let it go for a little bit. But for $20, this definitely feels worth it. The plastic doesn't feel too cheap. It's got a decent amount of weight to it. The outer edge is rubber, so you can bang around without fear of it breaking. It's got some nice interactive things for it. Of course, I would have absolutely loved to have a little push button that would leave this lit all the time. But since it's powered by button batteries, I understand that probably isn't possible. And I think it's that those are going to light up soon to go into standby mode. There you go. Once it's in standby mode, the sounds no longer work. Nothing's there. To get it back on, push, and then it'll continue flickering again. Very soon. There you go. And then you can see the sounds are back on. So yeah, highly recommend this. If you've been kind of iffy on the Tron Legacy toys, I don't blame you. I'm definitely not sold on them just yet. I think Spin Master isn't really handling it too well, but that's just me. But this is definitely a great way to start off. It's got a great feel to it. It feels like it's aimed a little more towards collectors than small children. However, small children could handle this and play with it very, very fine. It's definitely a great way to start your Tron Legacy collection, if you will. And I would say pick it up. Also, it's worth noting, it comes with a bunch of instructions that were folded up all nice and neat until I unraveled them. All they show is about 6 to 10 languages of how to turn on, how to switch batteries, how to, all that kind of stuff there. Yeah, but I guess that is it, guys. I hope I'll be doing more Tron toys in the future, but really, I haven't seen anything that really impresses me just yet, so we'll just have to wait and see. This, however, was quite a delight, and I am so happy I got it. Amazon.com has it for $20. If you have the Prime membership, you get free shipping on it. If not, Toys R Us and Company should have it soon. If not, now, I guess. Hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.